Hello friends, welcome to our channel Aha Jindagi Tricky Maths. In this lecture we will discuss square roots and we will mainly concentrate on how to find square roots using factorization method. So coming to what is square root? See, if x square is equal to y, okay? So if we take square roots both sides, what we will get? X will be equal to under root y. So we can say that the square root of y is x. Okay. So square root of y is x. And how we denote? That is, we denote by under root y will be equal to x. Okay. See, suppose we have to find the square roots of under root xy. So what we can do, if it is easy to find separately root of x and root of y, then we can break it into under root x into under root y. Then we find separately root x and root y and then take product of these two. Okay. Similarly, one more point is there. Suppose we have to find under root x by y. That is, it is a fraction. So what we can do, numerator we can take root separately and denominator we take root separately and then we can divide. Or if we don't want root in denominator, then we can rationalize it and multiply numerator and denominator by root y. Okay, the root y, so it will be under root xy divided by y. Okay. So if you find difficulty in finding the square root of a fraction, you use this method. So now coming to factorization method of square roots. See, one more method is there, that is division method. But in this lecture, we will concentrate on factorization method. So in this method, what do we do? We express the given number as a product of prime factors. Then we take product of all prime factors by taking only one number out of each pair of similar prime factors. So if we take example, then it will be easy to understand. Suppose we have to find square root of 144. Okay. So in terms of prime factors, how we can express it? It will be, see, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Okay. These are the prime factors. So we express in terms of pairs like 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 2 and 3 to the power 2 and take 1 out of each pair. So it will be 2 into 2 into 3. That is 12. So 12 is the square root of 144. Okay. So we will solve some problems. See, we have to evaluate square root of 6084 and second part square root of a decimal number which is equal to 0.0009. So how we can solve it? So first, one by one, we will solve 6084. So first we have to express 6084 as product of prime factors. So what are its factors? So in rough work you can calculate the prime factors. 6084, so it is 3042. Okay. Till the number is even, you can divide it by 2. So 1521. Now it is not divisible by 2. So you need to divide by 3, so 507. Again, if you divide it by 3, it will be 169. And now it is not divisible by 3, it will be divisible by 13. So what are its prime factors? See, 2 to the power 2 into 3 to the power 2 into 13 to the power 2. So take 1 out of each pair of different prime factors. So it will be 2 into 3 into 13. Okay. So square root of 6084 will be 78. Okay. Coming to second part, that is a decimal number 0.0009. So we will express it as fraction and it will become 9 divided by 10 to the power 4. Okay. So as we have discussed during the starting of the lecture, that we can take root of numerator separately and root of denominator separately. So it will be 3 divided by 100, and then if you divide it, you will get 0.03. Okay. So square root of given number will be 0.03. We will solve one more problem. See, we have to evaluate this one. So in this, how we should proceed? See, first we have to find the square root of 144. Okay. So it will be equal to under root 248 plus under root 52, and the square root of 144 as we have calculated will be 12. So again we have to find square root of 64. Okay. 52 plus 12, 64. So 248 and the square root of 64 is 8. So it is under root 256. Then we have to find prime factors of 256. So it will be 2 to the power 8. Or when you take out, so you divide 8 by 2, so it will be 4. So 2 to the power 4, or it is equal to 16. Okay, friends. So in this lecture we have seen how we can calculate square roots using factorization method and solve some problems. Okay, thank you.